town fish deal with the problem of overcrowding by sharing space with another creature, gigantic anemones. They've formed a relationship in which both parties benefit. Anemones have tentacles that are packed with stinging cells. Most fish, touching one, get a very nasty sting. But not the clownfish, thanks to the protective layer of mucus that covers its body. The clownfish keeps the anemone in good health by removing unwanted parasites. And in return, the anemone offers security. Its stinging cells ward off the sort of creatures which would otherwise threaten the clownfish. When the time comes for a pair to breed, that protection will be vital. A female may lay up to 1,000 eggs on the rock beneath her anemone home. As she delicately attaches them, the male follows closely behind, fertilizing the eggs as he goes. A week will pass before the young are ready to emerge. Hatching only happens at night, so to record it, we have to use infrared cameras in a specialized filming environment. This is the very first time that this behavior has been filmed. With gentle encouragement from their father, the young are helped on their way. Once the little larvae are set free, they're on their own. They'll spend the first few weeks of their life developing in the open ocean.